from the moment the movies learn to talk, audiences escape the depressed, rain-swept streets into a Hollywood dreamland full of nightclubs, martinis, and white telephones. Early Hollywood cinema was continental, inspired by sophisticated playwrights like Noel Coward and Ben Hecht. These films clung to the proscenium dimensions of the stage, making little distinction between dramatic theater and talking cinema. But the rise of fascism in Germany caused a mass influx of UFA personnel to invade the Hollywood studios, modernizing the medium and distancing it from its theatrical counterpart. Chief among these German immigrants was Fritz Lang. Successful in Germany for expressionistic films like Dr. Mabuse the Gambler, Metropolis, and Spies, Lang brought a darkness to the American cinema unforeseen in the industry. The noir film is credited as being created by John Huston in 1941's The Maltese Falcon, but really its origins can be found in Lang's first American film, 1936's Fury. Spencer Tracy plays a man falsely accused of murder, but instead of facing trial, he narrowly survives execution from a lynch mob. Tracy plots revenge on the mob by pretending to be dead and orchestrating a murder trial for all those involved. The film employs dark themes of justice and has a heavy stylistic use of shadow that won't be the Hollywood norm until after the end of World War II. Lang further predates the noir genre with his second American film, You Only Live Once, a loose retelling of the Bonnie and Clyde story that predates the Warren Beatty Faye Dunaway version by 30 years. In the early 1940s, Lang began the movement of anti-Nazi films in Hollywood with Manhunt. The film is significant as it was filmed in early 1941, months before the United States entered the war, yet the opening sequence features an assassination attempt on Hitler. Lang followed Manhunt with several other anti-Nazi films throughout the 1940s, like Hangmen Also Die, Ministry of Fear, and Cloak and Dagger. In fact, while Lang was still in Germany, he was criticized by Nazi officials for the anti-fascist propaganda of his 1933 film, The Testament of Dr. Mabuse. Though Lang would famously reject an offer from Goebbels to lead the Nazi film industry in favor of fleeing to the United States. In the 1950s, Lang pushed the rigid boundaries of the Hays Code by making films that featured extreme violence and liberal sexuality. The Big Heat has what some critics claim to be among the most violent scenes in classical Hollywood history, when Lee Marvin flings a pot of hot coffee into Gloria Graham's face, permanently scarring her. The film, While the City Sleeps, follows a team of journalists tracking down the lipstick killer, a murderer of a mother complex who kills attractive blondes. Though penetration is never directly referenced, it's implied that the murderer rapes the women once he has killed them. It's films like these that led to the gradual collapse of the Hays Code throughout the 1960s. Audiences were awakened from the Hollywood dreamland and hungered for violence and realism only possible with an end to censorship. Though Fritz Lang returned to Germany to make films in the late 1950s and ended his directing career before the inauguration of New Hollywood, it is impossible to see film as dark, violent, and paranoid as it became without the touch of his indelible hands.